I'm Bob Sweeney for Juno Channel 991, today here with Dodgeland head football coach, Doug Miller. Hi, Doug.
Hi, Bob.
How are you doing?
I'm doing really good.
Well, you've got 1 year in here at Dodgeland now. Why don't you just kind of give us your general opinion of how things went last year?
For starting new and, you know, not knowing a lot of the kids, a lot of the people in that, I was really, really pleased. Our kids were tremendous as far as their character and their work habits and how they approach practice every day. I just really enjoyed them, and the people at school have been wonderful to me. It's been a very good year for me.
Okay, and when you say year, it's that way for you, isn't it? It's not just a season.
Correct. I mean, I substitute teach at Dodgeland. I open the weight room after school. I coach track and field. So it's a total involvement on my part. Otherwise, I don't know if it's fair to the kids to just show up during the season, and it's probably not going to work that way.
Yeah, you certainly have a much better chance of doing well as a team if you think of it as being a year-round situation.
Right. You know, and we've done better in the weight room, and that takes, you know, a commitment every week to trying to find a way for kids that are three-sport athletes to get in there, to make it available to kids, and, you know, to sort of chart their progress and encourage them.
Right. Last year, what was your record?
We were 4-5.
And how did that meet expectations?
Not good and yet pretty good. You know, I mean, you always have high expectations. On a realistic view, these kids had not experienced a lot of wins, you know, especially those that were seniors. And, you know, I think they enjoyed winning some games and doing some things. I think we would have had a better season, but injuries caught up with us a little bit, and we lost some very valuable kids, and yet other kids got experience and did a good job.
Yeah, I was going through a lot of the games because I need to find clips for this program, and thinking of some key people you did lose to injuries last year was quite significant. Who were some of those people?
Well, Mike Ruziger. I mean, you know, Mike was probably our best pure football player, and we lost him about halfway through. Matt Moynihan, who was averaging 10.9 yards a carry, got hurt against Marcus Ann at our homecoming. Kyle Pitzlin, we lost early in the season. He was our starting right tackle and defensive tackle. So both Kyle and Mike were two-way players, and, you know, that's four position, and Moynihan was a big part of our offense as far as speed goes. You know, those three jump out, and we lost, some, you know, every once in a while we had a kid that missed a game or, you know, or something like that. But those three, we were just starting to get into what I thought was a pretty nice groove. And then when you lose those three kinds of kids, and some kids have to go two ways that aren't used to it, and somebody else has to switch a position. Mark Cranky switched positions to play for Kyle, and Mark did a nice job, but it was a transition.
Yeah. All right. This year, how many players do you have on the team this year, total, all four grades?
We have 42 on our roster.
How does that compare with last year?
Last year, once we got partway through the season, we had some kids join in with us. We had 47 on the roster, but probably only about 37, 38 that were playable once we got to midseason.
Mm-hmm. A lot of these guys, of course, played last year. You have some new guys who didn't come out last year?
We have a couple, yeah.
Okay.
The one is Brandon Kluge, who needed to take a year off, had an injury as a sophomore, and he's conditioned, and he's been really, really had a nice training camp, and it gives us that mature senior that will be able to do an awful lot for us, really.
Did you lose anybody who you thought you would have but did not come out?
We had some, you know, and that's probably the hardest part of the job is we know we've got some kids walking the hallway that would enjoy being with us if they were with us. And, you know, I don't see on a consistent basis, and, you know, there's days when I try to just come during lunch hour, and then stay for weightlifting just so I can work the lunchroom and talk, and just talk to kids, not talk football, but just talk to kids and, you know, try to get to know them and get a feel for them and stuff. But the kids, that could be with us and could enjoy it and could contribute, and we wish we had a few more of those kids.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's talk about some of these guys you have out now. First of all, let's go with the offense. What offense are you going to be running this year?
We're going to run a split beer. And we put in a jet sweep that normally isn't part of the beer package, but takes advantage of our speed and quickness. We're going to be a lot smaller up front, 45 pounds on an average smaller, but our bench is 35 pounds stronger than last year. So, and our speed is at that position is way above. You know, a kid like Austin Huebner is probably going to start at right tackle. He runs 4.640. You know, we're pretty fast. I don't think anybody is slower than a 5.1. So our line has some quickness, and so we had to develop some schemes that fit the way they can play.
And what is a Veer offense designed for besides speed?
Well, fast hitting, spread the field. Even though we're not, you know, going to throw it around a ton, but we can run bubble screens, we can run jet sweeps, we can run quick tosses, we come back inside and trap. It's designed for quick opening holes, fast decisions, optioning with your quarterback, things that will challenge the defense quickly. And that's why those two running backs are up closer to the line of scrimmage, and they're hitting holes fast.
They're in the formation referred to as a pro set, is that right?
People call it pro set, yeah. I mean,
You're traditional. You don't have a traditional fullback.
No, and that was our problem last year, is that we were running I, but we didn't have a fullback. That scared the heck out of the defense. You know, they were more running back, quick hitter guys, and in order to run the I, you got to have somebody that the other team does not like to run into. You know, I mean, he just has to be, and our backs more fit this beer.
All right. Okay, let's talk about some of the individuals that you have playing different positions.
Okay.
What would you like to start with?
We can talk about our quarterbacks, and let's start with Joe Kane. Joe's a senior. He comes off a very good track season where he was part of a relay that set school record in the 4x2. And he started a couple games for us last year when Matt Robinson was hurt, but he's played some other positions. So Joe's a good athlete with a 4 or 5 foot speed, and he's been throwing better than I expected, and just matured into the position. So he's one of our choices as a quarterback.
Okay, who else do you have?
We have a kid by the name of Cody Kutcher, and Cody is a very heady athlete. I was told about Cody as the season got going that, you know, he'll look good in practice, but he'll look better in competition, and there are kids that do that. And you know, so our competition for quarterback has been going on, but it also, you know, won't be decided until we get under fire and you know, kids are competing against other schools in a scrimmage or during the games. Cody's a defensive starter, also started at wide receiver and played some wing back for us last year. And then about halfway through the season, I just looked at him and, boy, that's a good athlete. We got to get him under center because you can always branch out, but it's hard to come back and play center if you don't get some background.
Okay, he's pretty short.
Yeah. They won't see him when he's running midline option. I mean, and serious, that's hard to keep track of a quarterback that's optioning a defensive tackle that's shorter, because you will never see him until he gets through.
You know, watching him play last year, I was impressed with how well he played with what I thought was kind of small guy, but he played well. He made some nice plays.
He made some very nice plays, you know, and that's exactly the point that, you know, we have to keep in mind, that we have some kids that when the ball's in the air on a Friday night, they're better than what they are on a Tuesday afternoon. It's just a trait that, you know, the good ones have. And so we're real pleased with what Cody did. And mm-hmm. and both those kids have the ability to play different positions, both offense and defense.
And have you been putting them at
yes.
different positions?
Okay. Yeah, so they've been getting background at other spots, and okay. you know, they'll be contributing no matter which one's playing quarterback.
Okay. What about this the junior varsity quarterback from last year, Nails, correct?
Cody's real close. Yeah, Cody Nails. You know, and our quarterback situation is very healthy right now because Cody did a real nice job on the junior varsity. He's 6'3", I mean, lefty, and I love lefties because I had a son that was a lefty and a daughter that played quarterback that was a lefty. But he throws the ball well. He sees things. You know, he uses his stature, and he's another kid that come game time does a very nice job. And then as we work our way down the classes, we have Zach Younger, who is a freshman now, that's 6'3", that ran a 4.7, that's very athletic, and is playing quarterback. So I really, and all those kids can play other positions. They can play wide receiver, they can play tight end. So, you know, we've got good athletes that are being trained as quarterbacks first, because that's, you know, you don't go very far if you don't have somebody there that can do a good job, but yet they're all gonna be able to contribute in different places. And so it's a very healthy position for us right now.
All right, good. Another position.
Running back. We returned two very good running backs. And the first one would be Jackson Seifzer. Jackson was our team MVP. He had about 869 yards last year, averaged over 6 a carry. But what people don't, you know, when they watch him play in that, he played very well, but he played on a pretty bad ankle about the last 5 weeks of the season. Because he was hurt going in. He rolled his ankle going into the Marcus Ann game. And probably, I was probably iffy on whether he played, and we pulled him out in the second half when we got down by 20. But he, as our best bench, he was our fitness winner. He ran 4.5. He also was on that relay that went to state and set school record. You know, he's 207 pounds, so he's a nice specimen to have back there. And right now, teaming with him is Andrew Mountain. And Andrew was one of those kids that I was told by Coach Selkert, you know, you want to see Andrew in games. Because boy, when games come, things just happen. And unfortunately, I put him in our first game, and early he fumbled, so that I lost that perspective for a little bit. And then it was about 2-3 weeks later that, you know, he started doing some things in games and, you know, opening our eyes. And he had 400 some yards in about 3.5 games of playing the running back position. We got two really good starters that are big kids that run in space well. And then the other, you know, the quarterbacks are going to carry the ball, but also Matt Moynihan is going to be playing a wing back. So, you know, he can be listed as a runner or a receiver, but before he was hurt, you know, he averaged 10.9 yards a carry and had a big, huge play for us at off a quick toss. Against Montello, Princeton, Green Lake. And we were able to win that by a point. And that was a big win for us. I mean, that was important that the kids knew that they were, you know, were stepping up the ladder a little bit and could play with you know, teams that had been traditionally good. Mm-hmm.
Last year, another running back you had, I think he's back, is Taylor Rayon. Is he running back this year?
Taylor is back this year, yeah. And he's playing left guard. And you know, we moved Taylor during camp, and Taylor's our second strongest kid. Um, he he went from linebacker, and we started playing more five fronts, so we moved him to nose. And our offensive line needed another senior that could do a great job up there. And, you know, for us it was a natural fit, and it took Taylor about 2 hours of practice time. At first he said, well, can I go back and forth? I said, you certainly can. Then he came back, he said, I'll just stay over here. He says, I understand, I get it, you know. And he's been very good. He's really been studying hard to understand the concepts. But, you know, he's a very good athlete, so he's catching on to this stuff quick, and he's put the time in the weight room probably as much or more than anybody that we have.
All right, you've talked about three running backs. Do you have anybody backing them up?
We have Josh Burrow, who Josh played some running back last year, and Josh is probably going to start at strong safety for us. At least, I mean, he looks pretty strong there, and then he's going to back up the running back spots. And you know, Josh isn't as big as those other two, but you don't notice a big difference when he's, I mean, he does a very, very nice job. And you know, we're looking for Josh to be on a rotation. You know, and the other kid that hasn't been able to practice yet, Paul Gruenwald, and Paul, when he's cleared, will be an awful nice fit there also.
We're running the other team's plays.
I watched him play junior varsity last year, and he played fullback. He had some real nice runs right up the middle right off the center. Holes opened up really nice for him, but he dragged some people, so I can see where he'd be a pretty good player for you.
Yeah, he will be. I mean, and he's got nice vision, so like when you saw him go through and it looked like holes opened up, he probably was able to just adjust himself enough to get through a smaller crack, and you know, some kids have that knack of being able to find those little creases and seams and run hard so that when that seam is there, they're hitting the secondary on full bore. But yeah, we expect a lot of nice things out of Paul. I mean,
all right, next position then.
Receiver. Our starting tight end will be Davy Grunberg.
Well, Davy Grunberg.
Yes. Grunberg.
Yep.
Yeah. Even I. Yeah.
Yep.
Davy has gotten bigger. He's 6'3", 185. He's gotten stronger. And out of that maturity and strength development, he's gotten faster. And he did a nice job last year. But he gives us just a better body to work with. And Davy is very smart. He's a three-sport athlete. I expect him to be awfully good there. Backing him up is Derek Zimi. And Derek, we just sort of threw a little something at him the other day. Is Derek's been doing a real nice job at tight end behind Davy, but we also have a need for maybe another lineman that can be in the mix. So he's going to learn tight end and be able to play the guards for us also. But you know, he's a tough kid who's very coachable and do anything we ask him. You know, so he was, I'll do that. And so we're pretty healthy there. Our wide receiver position right now, Topher Jessman. Topher played the wing when Moynihan got hurt last year. He's played defense. He started since he's been a sophomore. He's gotten faster. He's done a good job in the weight room. I mean, he's 140-something, and he had a 220 bench for us. You know, that's pretty good. That's getting a lot out of what he's got there. And that added strength has helped his foot speed. So expect good things out of Topher there. Behind him, we've got a combination of Cody Kutcher and Tristan Miller. So we've got kids that can play back there. You know, Tristan was a defensive starter as a sophomore for us last year, and just makes things happen, does things very well. So we're pretty healthy on that. And we need the multiple guys at split receiver, because if Matt Moynihan needs a rest or something, then Topher slides over to that wing.
Okay.
He can run out of that position.
All right. Another position.
Offensive lineman then. You know, and save the best for last, because
if you don't have linemen, your backs aren't doing anything.
It's where the game is won. We're smaller, but we are very aggressive up front. And our center right now is Brandon Kluge. And we talked a little bit about Brandon being back out, but he has had very good training camp. He's a very skilled kid, so, you know, let's long snap. There it goes, and that looks good. He may be our best punter.
It's going to be hard to do both.
It's going to be very hard to do both. So we have another long snapper that'll get down the field really well. But I mean, he has a lot of skills. I think he could probably throw the ball. I mean, I know he does. When we throw around and that, I mean, he's got a very good arm, which I love my punters to have a good arm, because if we want to run fake, I like that part, and he certainly could do that really well. But his offensive line play has been very good, and that's been a very big bonus for us to get him back. Our right guard returns in Logan Stouffer, and Logan was our top lineman of the year last year. Just a very, very tough kid, lifts well, but just sort of one of those throwback kids, 5'10", 195, and likes to line up against people, and nobody will intimidate him. He's very good at trapping, so he gives us a very good right guard. And then we have Taylor Rayom over at left guard, and Taylor's real similar to Logan, so our interior three are mature senior guys that work well together. Backing up all three right off the get-go is going to be Brandon Ketter. And Ketter's had a real good fitness test. He lifted really well. He's worked hard. His weight's up. He's about 195 pounds now. So he's been on a normal rotation. He's been going from one spot to the next, and so he's been with that starting group as much as those other three, because we've got to keep our depth solid, and if we need to put someone in there, he has to be comfortable with them. And of course, snapping the ball is very crucial. It's my favorite position, finding a center centers that we can trust and rely on. So that gives us four kids, and then five with Derek Zimi in the middle. Our tackles right now, our right tackle is Austin Huebner. And Austin had a nice wrestling season. He lettered for us last year as a sophomore. He had a very good track season, a lot of foot speed, very strong kid. So we get a lot out of him. We'll pull him all the way on to the opposite side to trap. We'll pull him on quick pitches. He'll outside release on our jet sweeps. And yet he's a tough enough kid where he can come down on linebackers and handle people over the top of them. And with the Veer schemes, he doesn't have to latch onto a big guy and keep him for a long time. He's just got to get into him and take a thigh pad away and keep scrambling. Our left tackle is Tyler Krause. Tyler started there last year as a sophomore. Now he's dropped 20 pounds, and he's a little stronger, but he does things so much quicker and forcefully than he did last year. The big sophomore was a little careful. He's matured. He plays with a lot more strength than he has, but those long levers at 6'4", sometimes isn't conducive to big benching. but yet you can strike a pretty good blow. And he does. And so I'm real pleased. We're using Troy Stocky, a sophomore, to back up the two tackle spots. And Troy came out near the start of the school year last year and has been really a nice, pleasant addition. I think our kids went out and recruited a few of their friends, and Troy will be a very nice football player, but that rounds out our depth. So offensively, we stay healthy. I mean, I like what we have to work with.
What about the other side of the ball then?
The other side of the ball. Our defensive backs, we got a lot of kids that return that have experience. I actually don't think we graduated any that were full-time starters. A few kids, you know, when Joe Kane got hurt, somebody else played, but Tristan Miller started almost the whole season at right corner last year. He looks very good, very heady kid. He's not blazing fast, but he plays fast on the field. Rarely does he let people get behind him. He's very smart.
Steve's in the right position.
He's positioned. He's intelligent. He understands how fast he is and maybe how fast his opponent is. And tries and does a very good job of keeping things in front and then making tackles when he has to make tackles. And that's a good defensive back. Cody Kutcher played some safety last year and some corner, but pretty much started the whole year. So we had two sophomores starting back there last year. And like we talked about Cody, he's pretty sharp when it comes to doing things on the field. He seems to be able to do things under pressure well. You know, so we have Cody. Topher Justman started the whole year. And sometimes Topher played a little bit outside linebacker, but as the season went on, he was mainly in the secondary. Topher's a third-year starter. And Topher does a great job.
John.
So we're pretty solid there, but then we've got Joe Kane, who will play back there, could start. I mean, we're not sure how we're going to use all these, you know, but... couple guys that are playing both outside linebacker and defensive back, like Matt Moynihan. His brother Dan is gonna start in the scrimmage. And Dan Moynihan, very good athlete. He's fast. I mean, he's one of our top eight kids as far as 40 dash goes. He'll do a nice job.
Get it!
Moving on to our linebackers, Taylor Rayom and Andrew Mountain were two of our starting inside linebackers last year.
Time running the ball.
The other outside, so they're going to work in the middle. Brandon Ketter can work in the middle also. On the outside, Josh Burrow will start off as one of those guys. And Josh started most of the year last year. We've got quite a bit back. Gruenberg right now is a returning starter at outside linebacker, but I think we're gonna, you know, he's returning there, but I think we're gonna move him up into defensive end because we've got so many kids that run well and can tackle well.
Tackle well?
Tackle well. Even though we don't practice tackle a lot. You know, that's sort of the catch 22 of football. Do you want 37 kids that have had a lot of that haven't done a lot of live contact, or do you want 33 kids and have four on the sidelines because you've overdone the tackling on?
Well, if I can see some good tackling this year out of Dodgeland players, I'm going to be very happy. Yeah. Because it has been at times painful to watch the tackling at Dodgeland. So it's going to be an improvement this year.
I think so. Defensive linemen, let's start at defensive ends. Jackson returns as a defensive end. And Jackson had a very good year last year. We've adjusted our scheme so that our ends don't have outside responsibility. They can be aggressive to the ball. Things bounce outside of them. They've got somebody assigned to be out in the flats. In the past, they had outside responsibility and just sort of limited how aggressive they could be in closing things down.
He had a very good fourth quarter against Montello, Princeton, Green Lake, if you remember that.
Oh, yeah. I remember the whole game.
He got three major sacks
to
just drive them back. It was amazing. It was fun to watch.
And I think Jackson understood he had a mismatch against somebody and that they were going to need to be throwing the ball. They weren't very successful running it against us, so he could just tee off and go. And there's a case of he being free to just go and not have to worry about keeping things corralled. You know, we want our guys that are rushing off the edge to rush on the outside shoulder pad so that they don't spin out.
Mm-hmm.
But they're not responsible for any kind of flare routes or, you know, sweep. Is somebody else is going to come up on a sweep and they're going to fill from the inside out. Not they're the person responsible for taking sweep. So it allows them to be aggressive like Jackson was there.
Mm-hmm.
And then Davey, who was playing behind Jackson last year, will move opposite Jackson.
He played quite a bit there though last year, did he not?
Oh, he started the whole year at outside. You know, in order to get our best athletes on the field. And like I said, Davey's bigger, he's stronger, he's faster. He'll give us a nice bookend on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
And then Derek Zimi has been working both sides as a backup at defensive end. And Derek will do a good job there. And then we always have a kid like Tyler Krause who is playing a defensive tackle right now, but Tyler's a big, rangy kid that he can move out of play end. Our tackles right now, Logan Stouffer is playing one tackle. And Logan started there last year and did a nice job. He's strong, he's quick off the ball. And then the other tackle will be we're going to alternate Tyler Krause and Austin Huebner. And our two offensive tackles are going to sort of alternate at that other defensive tackle and keep them fresh. And, you know, we may see one that needs to be on the field more than the other after a couple of weeks.
You know, not that junior varsity is at the same level as varsity, but Austin Huebner just game after game after game, he was causing the opponent's offense all kinds of trouble, making many tackles behind the line of scrimmage. You are not playing live now yet, so it's hard for you to tell.
Right. We'll know a lot more after tomorrow night,
mm-hmm.
you know, Friday at our scrimmage. Brandon Kluge has been working at defensive tackle, but he's also, we started defensive tackle, and that's where he started. But then all of a sudden one day he wanted to go with the linebackers, and which I really liked because inside linebacker is a very valuable position. So the more good athletes you have that are working there. But I think we've sort of settled on he's going to back up the linebackers but also play some end. And I'm not, if I can get away with it, I try to protect my centers a little bit. Because it's an awful crucial spot to pull out of your lineup. So there's been years where my centers have gone both ways or almost, you know, but if I can get away with it, and got other people that do a good job. That's so Brandon's been working defensively, but
and different positions.
Yeah, I mean because I think if we need to use him, we won't be real sure on where we want to use him depending on how healthy we stay or how well somebody plays. You know, if we have a position that's not playing well, I think I could slide him over there and he would play well.
Does that cover the defense then?
Yeah.
Okay, specials.
Topher Justman returns as our punter. And Topher had a nice season. He doesn't have a big leg, but he does some pretty good things with getting the ball out of there, ball placement. And he kicks better in a game than he does in practice, you know. Brandon Kluge punts big in practice. So I don't mind having those two choices because, you know, before Brandon, I was perfectly fine with what Topher would give us. Our best long snapper is Brandon, so that makes Topher a little more valuable. But we do, you know, like when we run some sprints, we'll have all our kickers kicking the ball downfield and we'll sprint to the ball instead of just,
right,
you know. And Matt Moynihan happened to grab a ball and started snapping it. Well, it looks really good. I mean, some
he's
kids
really
just
small.
But you legally, you're not allowed to hit the snappers. Yeah. So you can't line up on him. Yeah. You can't hit him, and you know.
Yeah.
And he's small, but he's very strong.
Yeah.
I mean, as a wrestling coach, you would have liked
yes,
to work with Matt Moynihan.
He would have done well.
Yes, he would. You know, both those boys are.
Yeah.
So, but what he does give you is, seeing you can't hit him, everybody's centers are usually down the field pretty mm-hmm. fast. Now we have a kid that's run 4-5 going down the middle of the field.
He's not afraid to tackle either, is he?
No. I mean, he's a. It would be a good scheme to have him snap and Brandon punt, and he would be, because we were doing that last night. We were alternating between the two combinations, mm-hmm. you know. And boy, when he goes down the field, it's fast, you know. And then our two fly guys on the outside, and those three guys come down. And, you know, Brandon puts the ball up in the air pretty high. They come down, but when the ball gets there, so it'll be interesting. I mean, we've got a long way to go to get to that decision.
Yeah.
Our kicker, Zach Forden, came out last year, and he's a soccer-style kicker. It's the only position he works at. And although I do have him go with the defensive backs so that he works on, he goes through the tackling technique drills mm-hmm. and things like that. But he pulled his hip flexor last year while kicking early. So we never saw him in a game. And he's a junior right now. He is a very good kicker.
He's accurate?
Oh, he's a very good kicker. Yeah, yeah. He even, you know, when a snap comes in, if the snap's not right over, he knows how to adjust his approach so that he's there when the ball's down. And it's very subtle, but, you know, kids that are good can do that. And so it seems very fluid, even if the guy has to, the holder has to catch it on his hip and pull it over, and it's just a split second leg. He's anticipating that as he's swinging through. We should have some very good return people in Kutcher.
Can't read his number, sorry. High snap, that's 12, I believe. Nice punt, though. And on the return was number 25.
Joe Kane.
Come on, Jackson. Get to see you, Jackson.
Moynihan. Jackson returns kickoffs. Andrew, I mean, we've got some athletes that are good runners. So, you know, I like that position. I mean, I think we're sitting pretty good, and they've been catching punts and things. So,
what about coaches?
Tom Selker returns as his in his 21st year, and Tom is running the defense. Does a great job. Has been, you know, I think he's embraced having a little more responsibility, and you know, he's putting a lot of his own time, his free time, into schemes and making the defense his. He's got all new names for positions, and the kids are having fun with it. And him and I worked together. We drew up a package that'll look a little different, and that we got people moving a lot, because we're not going to be, we don't have anybody over 205 playing defense, and so we got these quick guys that have strength and power up front, but you know, I don't think we can leave them stand still and let people get a beat on us. The other coaches, first coach that we hired this summer was Quinn Pieper, and Quinn just got done with a very successful starting career at UW Oshkosh in the offensive line. And again, the offensive line is something very dear to me, because that's that's how our offense works.
You were there to protect you, right?
Well, you know, as a high school quarterback, I learned to value those guys an awful lot. But as a coach, I mean, it's really crucial that you have a good offensive line coach. Then we had another position open up a little later in the summer, and I called Quinn up, and I asked him, I said, I'm looking for somebody that can coach our tight ends, defensive ends, maybe help out with the offense, you know, tight ends, offensive tackles, while you take the interior. You know, do you know anybody that would fit that role? And he said, no. No, he thought a little more. He says, well, he named somebody that was a lot older than him. And then I said, Quinn, do you have a brother? He goes, oh, yeah. So we hired Derek. I told Quinn, I said, you young people, you know, you're great at thinking outside the box, but sometimes your answer's inside the box. And they have been great. I mean, our kids enjoy that exuberance that they bring onto the practice field. They're very good at technique and understanding what to do. You know, Derek spent some time at playing tight end at St. Cloud, and he's got a very good background. Quinn's got great handle on offensive line play. You know, I mean, they're coaches, and that's been very good. And then I was able to pick up a volunteer from a guy that I've known for some years that teaches over at Hughesford, and his name is Derek Swieger. And so I knew Derek was a good person, a good guy. I wasn't sure, I hadn't coached with him before, and what kind of coaching he had done. And he did a year of junior high coaching over at Johnson Creek, where my wife works. That's how I met him to start with. But he's been very good, and he's working with our inside linebackers and running backs.
Well, the upcoming season, first game, what about that?
Now, you're talking about the first game we have scheduled, or
the first game we have scheduled?
Houstonsburg can only do what they can do at that point.
Right.
You know, and so I got on, and I've talked with Travis Wilson, who runs WIS Sports in the state. Mm-hmm. And so he's given me some leads of schools that are questionable right now. Mm-hmm. And so we've been trying to keep tabs. We sent out a couple emails yesterday. And, you know, sorry to ask, but we're just concerned. You know, we're looking for week one, and we heard your statuses. Mm-hmm. And I was on this morning, so we haven't found an answer yet. Mm-hmm.
But you have some possibilities.
We have some possibilities, and we'll look up and we'll keep looking until next week, Thursday, probably.
Yeah. So then the game after that is Cambria-Friesland, is that right?
Yeah.
Well, they were a pretty good team last year.
Oh, they're a very good team, yeah.
But what I remember from that game is two separate games.
Yeah.
First half and second half. Talk about that a little bit.
Well, you know, the Houstonsburg game, I don't think we went out there week one last year with the same kind of intensity we needed to have when we played Cambria. And, you know, maybe that some, you know, I guess when anything doesn't happen right, it's my fault. But it wasn't, you know, and so we went through that game and we didn't play real well. I thought they played pretty well. But it wasn't until we played Cambria and we saw how fast they played, mm-hmm. and that our kids finally, you know, boy, if we're gonna compete with this, we've gotta play better. And we've got to play more opportune. And, you know, we let Cambria get a score right before half that put it at 23-0 at halftime. And we kept very, very calm at halftime, and but yet challenged that we got to do this. Don't be concerned about a score. Get one score on them. Just bring it a little closer. We're able to do that. We had a big play with pass up, you know. Well, the big play was Kutcher stripping the ball down the 1 yard line to stop him from scoring.
Our ball, I think. You're at the three, inside the three.
We couldn't punch it out of there, and so we
threw it.
we took a shot with Jackson out of the backfield. And but I think your point, I think we played a whole lot different in the second half.
Well, I think their coach mentioned that in the paper.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Jim's a good guy too. I mean, he would recognize somebody else's kids, and but we did. We played better, and I think that was very good for us. And so, you know, looking for a week one game, you know, we want somebody that's gonna force us to play well.
Well, let's hope that's a week two game. They get almost everybody back.
They get almost everybody back. Yes, they do. And it'll be a great, I mean, I'm really looking forward to it. I love it on our schedule, because if we're going to come back and compete with some of the schools in our conference, we've got to find out where we're weak. And playing a school like Cambria, you know, they will make sure that we know where we're strong and where we're weak, and that'll be very healthy for us. So it'll be a nice challenge to see how we've progressed. And you know, they beat our conference champ Deerfield 27-0 during the middle of the season. Mm-hmm. So yeah, they have a good team, mm-hmm. and they're well coached. And it's a great game to have on the schedule.
All right, do you know who you have the next game after that?
I have my schedule down here. I think we have Oshkosh Lords.
Yeah, I think you do.
Yeah, we're at. I remember that one. And so we play 5:00.
And you go up there, right?
Week three.
Yeah.
Yep. At Titan Stadium. And so that'll be fun. That'll, again, be a nice challenge. They have a very good program. They lost a lot of good seniors, but they've got a good program. So it'll mm-hmm. be a nice challenge.
Any other teams you'd like to mention about that? Would you expect to, say, challenge for the championship this year?
The school that probably handled us the worst last year is Marcus Ann. You know, the Ruziger went down, Moynihan went down early in that game. It was 0-0 with 5 minutes to go in the half, and then all of a sudden it was 20-0 at half. Second half, I think our kids got down a little bit, and I think Marcus Ann enjoyed getting on us a little bit. that's a game I'm looking forward to. They'll be very good. They return almost all their people. They've got big linemen up front, and that'll be a great challenge for us to see if we've progressed to the point where we're going to be able to play against the better schools in our league, because I think they would be our favorite.
Okay. I think I mentioned this last year. I thought the conference had become much more balanced as with the teams like Deerfield and the Phoenix and Lords, Marcus Ann.
Partyville.
They all seem to be pretty even.
Yeah.
You know, it seems that this way this year again?
I think so. You know, but
I mean, that's hard to say.
Yeah. You know, depends on how the year plays out. You know?
But you think Marcus Ann is probably the best team this year?
If I had to take somebody's lineup off of last year's, mm-hmm. what they have returning, they would have the most returning. They have two quarterbacks that are really good. They're really good basketball players. They're both back. So they have good athletes. They have the big kids up front returning.
Okay. Well, anything else?
I think I'm good.
You're enjoying your job. You're enjoying your job.
Oh, I love it. Yeah.
That always helps, doesn't it?
Yes. I mean, I still have a lot of time left that I want to coach. So
right.
this has been fun for me, and plan on continuing for a long time.
Purple looks good on you.
I love purple. I went to Marinette High School, and I started in purple, so it's only fitting that I. And our rival that we hated wore maroon.
Oh,
so.
My goodness. Well, thank you very much.
Thank you, Bob.